my game-changing moment was time frame. Okay, this is 1968-69, and I need to put it in perspective in the way of, at that time, there were three television networks. When you did a primetime TV show, the world seen you. So, I'm in New York City on, what was it, Broadway, on 56 or something, Ed Sullivan Theater. And this was the first time we did it, Sly and the Family Stone, right? That was, which I was a founding member of. So we're at the, in the afternoon at the sound check and to get set up to do the Ed Sullivan show, which was live in those days. And everybody was up in the green room. I was kind of wandering around. I found myself was down in the studio, and there was no one there. I'm sitting, sat in one of the seats in the front, you know. And I'm looking at the stage, and there was I think it was what, Ed O'Shaughnessy, drum head, and then over here we got my set is set up. And I said, I'm 17 and a half years old, 18 years old. I'm saying, wow, it's interesting, you know. Here I am, right? I remember I had seen it when I was, I don't know, 8 or 9 years old. This is where Elvis Presley debuted. This is the same stage that the Beatles debuted. And when you did that show, the next day, your world changed. You know, I mean, everybody recognized you. I said, well, what am I doing different? I was doing the same thing yesterday, but you know, you did the Ed Sullivan show, and it was like, it was a wonderful thing. The whole world seeing you, and if it was good, it was great, you know. So I have to say that that was a powerful thing. Media in those days, television, and it was definitely a game changer. And we did what we did, and you know, the whole world heard it.